wooden toy rocket is in the shape of cone mounted on cylinder as shown in the adjacent figure. Okay, so we have a diagram here like this. Rocket is in the form of a cone mounted on cylinder. All right. The height of the entire rocket is 26 centimeter, while the height of the conical part is 6 centimeter. Height of this entire rocket from here to here, it is 26, right? Whereas height of the conical part is 6 centimeters. If height of this conical part is 6, height of the cylinder will be equal to 20, right? Because total is 26. All right. Base of the cone has a diameter of 5 and cylinder diameter is 3 centimeters. See here. This is cylinder, this is cone, right? So this diameter is equal to how much? 5 given. So radius will be equal to 2.5, half of the diameter. And diameter of the cylinder is equal to 3 given, 3 centimeters. So radius will be half of that, 1.5 centimeters. Okay. If the conical portion is to be painted orange and the cylindrical portion is to be painted yellow, find the area of the rocket painted with each of these colors. Take pi as 3.14. Okay. All right. So that means we are painting this part orange, right? What part? This curved surface area of cone plus this part also, right? This will be orange. Okay. And let us write orange here. And this part, this whole thing. And this one circle, right? We are painting yellow. We should find how much is the orange area we are painting and how much is the yellow area we are painting. Okay. All right. Now, let us first find yellow area. Area to be painted yellow. Area to be painted yellow. All right. Now, if we draw the diagram again of the cylinder, see, these two surfaces are being attached, right? So cone and cylinder we are attaching. So that means this part will not be there anymore, isn't it? So we need not find that. So we'll paint this part, which is curved surface area of cylinder. We know it is equal to 2 pi rh and one circle pi r square plus pi r square. So this much is yellow, isn't it? We'll paint this much area yellow. Let us substitute the values. Or can we take anything common? Yes, we can take pi r common. So this will be 2h plus r here. All right. So 3.14 into r cylinder 1.5 into 2 into height of the cylinder 20, right? 20 plus r 1.5. So this will be 3.14 into 1.5. 2 into 20, 40 and 1.5, 41.5. So if you multiply this, you will get 195.465 centimeter square. Okay. So this much we are painting yellow. All right. Now let us find orange. See, orange is little tricky because this is pi RL, right? Curved surface area. We'll paint this orange and we'll also paint, see here, rocket is like this, right? We'll also paint this part. Students will forget to find this. Okay. This part is also orange now. Now, if you see this cone from the bottom, it will look like this, something like this. This is the cone, base of the cone. This is the base of the cylinder, isn't it? So that means what? This part will paint orange, right? How should we find this shaded region? Area of big circle minus area of small circle, isn't it? So shaded region here will be pi r square. Let the radius of the big circle be capital R, radius of the small circle be small r. So pi r square minus pi r square, right? Okay. So can we take pi common? Yes. R square minus r square. This is like a square minus b square, right? This is in the form of a square minus b square. So can we write it like this? Pi into r plus r into r minus r small r. So pi is 3.14 capital R. How much was capital R? 2.5. This one, right? Diameter was equal to 5, right? Diameter of the cone was equal to 5. So radius will be 2.5. And small r was 1.5. So this is 2.5 minus 1.5. So 3.14, 2.5 plus 1.5 will give us 4. 2.5 minus 1.5 will give us 1 only, right? So this will give us 12.56 centimeter square. All right. Okay, now we need to find pi RL. Okay, so pi is 3.14 R, capital R here, right? So this is 2.5 into L. We don't know what is the value of L. Okay, so let us take the cone again. L is slant height, right? L is equal to how much? We don't know. We know the height is equal to 6. Height of the conical part was 6 centimeters given, and radius is 2.5, right? So using Pythagoras theorem, we can find the value of this L. It is hypotenuse only, right? So this will be equal to h square plus r square. So this is 6 square plus 2.5 square. So 6 square is 36, 2.5 whole square. See, 25 whole square is 625, right? So 2.5 whole square will be 6.25. So this is 42.25. I'll write again, 42.25 root. Okay, now 42.25, what is this root? 6.5. okay, you can use this method, 42.25, and find the value of root 42.25, right? In one or two videos we have studied this, how to find the roots of decimal values. Okay, so this is the value of L, 6.5. so let us substitute it here, 6.5 centimeters. Okay, now if you multiply all these three, we'll have 51.025. okay, but how much is the orange area? Area to be painted orange, area to be painted orange is this, right? 12.56 plus 51.25. okay, this whole part, curved surface area 51.025, and this shaded region is 12.56. so it is the sum of this two, right? So 12.56 plus 51.025, it will be equal to 63.585. okay, 63.585. so this much area will paint orange. Okay, and what is the yellow area? 195.465 centimeter square. All right.